So we're live. We're live. Alright. Wow. So, getting in the Christmas spirit here, live on the Melbourne Football Club's social media networks. And so for those who don't know, I studied engineering at Monash University, so they've picked me to put up the Melbourne Football Club's Gingerbread House. So it's, I've got all these pieces lying around, I've got all these bowls full of stuff, and I probably shouldn't be eating because I'm trying to be professional, but I'm a great chef as well, so hopefully it gets it all going. That's probably not a great start. I need some, I guess this is icing. It's red, everything is red and blue, that's probably smart. Feel free to chip in, I don't even know what that is. Anyone who's out there watching who knows about this sort of stuff. I figure this is gonna be like the stuff that holds it together. The glue. I think I'll start there. See if I can get a few of these pieces together. So I think the first place to start is probably the wall. That one stands up by itself, that's a good start. That's pretty good, as far as that. Okay, I'm gonna do the front door. I guess you sort of put them together, right? That should be pretty simple.
We've got Eleanor is a huge fan of the sweater.
Oh yeah, I'm actually known for my fashion around the club as well, so it's good to finally get some feedback. Tell you what, that's actually standing up all right. So that's one bit. I guess now I'm just going to do the exact same for this other side.
Annabelle says you're a master chef.
Well, I actually think so. The first year boys had they're living in this share house at the moment, and they invited a few of the older boys to come around and help everyone, help them learn how to cook and stuff like that. And they picked me first, obviously, because I'm the world's greatest chef. And so, this how long does it take this stuff to set? The glue, does it just set pretty instantly, or
see how you go? I reckon.
See how we go. So I'm putting the back on now. Just I'm gonna be honest, I feel like I'm actually doing alright. Considering the number of gingerbread houses I've made in my life has come to a grand total of zero. Which I mean I'm doing half bad, so I'm putting the back on. There you go. That's standing in one piece at least. Doesn't have a roof yet. We've got a. Is this a door? Oh, I should put that on a bit earlier, maybe. That's okay. I'll just wing it and go to the roof. You know what? I'm gonna change it up. Get the glue going. We don't have two spoons. I'll stick with red. Blue will be my decoration. I'll keep the red going. The red's blue. Mate, fix. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Get all this stuff in. So I've actually got this bed going at the moment with Clayton Oliver and Jack Viney, that I'm not allowed to have any junk food until Christmas. And so I've got all these lollies around me. It's taking every ounce of my strength to not cook in for myself.
A couple of people have said that.
Have they really?
Yes.
I think they've had a good eye. It's all about preparation's key to sustain the footy. You just need to get a good plan, you need to stick to it.
Helen thinks you need to use more icing.
Well, Helen, that's an interesting observation. I'll lather it on for you. Especially for the roof. I feel like these four bits are meant to stand up. Whereas the roof is half a chance to fall off, isn't it? Except when I put it on. That's a fair bit. Alright. I'll put them on at the same time. One at a time. Alright, well, here goes nothing. That one, if there's too much ice in here, you're in trouble. Oh no. This could all come down very quickly. Oh no, damage control.
Harms, he's tuned in. Oh no.
It's alright. Reset. Oh no, this is bad. It's all Harms' fault. Stop watching. Have I done this right? Oh dear. Alright, new plan. I think what the problem was is because see how I was doing it like that? It needs to be like that so that the roof can lean on these bits. That's the problem. I've decided. You know what? I'm just gonna have to start again with the hole. So I'm gonna do it on the inside walls this time. This doesn't want to stay out. Alright, that's okay. That's a wall there. I'm sure I'm just going to say something like that.
Yeah, Craig says put the walls on the outside.
Yeah, Craig's got the idea. Well, I mean, I also have the idea, but it took me a little while to get there. Come on, let's sit together. This is a mess.
Hugh says this is a debacle.
Well, it was looking good until about 5 seconds ago. Who's cooking stuff is this? Because I don't think it's coming that clean. Alright, so there's a wall. Stay up. Alright. So good, that's good. You know, see, so that stuff needs to. There we go. Oh! Nailed it.
A lot of questions asking if they can get this sweater.
Can we get the sweater?
Yes, is available at the Demon Shop.
It's available at the Demon Shop, but what about the hat? Has there been any feedback about the hat?
A few questions as to where the helmet is, as opposed to the hat.
Well, the helmet. The helmet's for crash and bash work. This is all about finesse. You can't be running around headbutting stuff when you're trying to create a masterpiece, can you? This will be great. Does that count? It's up?
Now we're going to decorate.
That's easy. That's the easy part. I'm just going to reinforce all this stuff with a bit of...
Can Kelly says try twisting the piping bag if you want more. And you can't forget the door as well.
The door, of course not. Now, what? So I've got decorations. I'm not really sure what decorations. If anyone's got any ideas, I'm open to suggestions. This is a team house, not just mine. It's everyone's. This probably won't fit. I don't want to ruin it by knocking it over. It's halfway in.
Do the door like it's open, Sharon says.
Yes, the door is open. Bang. Alright, now it's time to decorate. So I've got this blue. I'm going to go blue for the decoration. Just change it up. Because the red's got to go.
Tyler said some sprinkles on the roof.
So what sprinkles? I've got blue, pink, or I guess multicolour is probably the best way to describe it. Middle one, hundreds and thousands. Let's get some of this blue stuff going first. That's a big scoop. I want to make sure that it doesn't fall over. That's what I'm pretty worried. So I reckon we get something like that going to like support it. Up around the front so it doesn't fall over. That's not a bad place to start. Should be an artist as well, maybe. Alright. I'm going to blue this bit. Oh, yes. Oh, oh, oh. Now we're talking. Does that look good? As what I think it looks? Okay, maybe this one's a little bit. This one's a bit fatter than the pink stuff.
Brody said no.
No, not a fan of decorating.
Unfortunately not, sorry.
I don't like that. That's alright, I can save it with. I need some of these. I think, it's probably one of these. So this blue stuff's hopefully sticky. Bang. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I want a jelly baby on the top. That'll be Clary. I'll call him Clary because it's red and Clary's running. That's alright. That blue stuff needs to hold on. Now I'm sprinkling. Everything's red and blue, so I feel like I can't go too wrong. What's the best flat way to sprinkle? A little bit of that. That's too much. That's too high. Actually, you know what? No, it's not. We're allowed to get a bit messy. That's alright. Oh, one more little thing has dropped off.
Sarah asks, what's your favourite Christmas memory?
My favourite Christmas memory. So I remember back when I was 5 or 6 years old that we always used to leave out cookies and milk for Santa and carrots for his reindeer. And one year, so I was a bit cheeky, I was like, I'll cash this guy and his reindeer. And there was actually a posse in our backyard that ran and stole one of the carrots, and I thought it was one of the reindeer, so I went out and started trying to hunt down this possum. And I realised it was a possum, but not an actual reindeer, but it was pretty funny. That was a long time ago now. Wouldn't recommend that to anyone, by the way. It's good fun. We run 100-100s every year at Christmas as well, me and my brothers, which is always a laugh. do. It's gonna be like a little front yard. All there. It's all in the presentation.
Clary's tuned in. He sounds impressed.
Clayton Oliver?
Yep.
That's you there. You're a little rainer sitting on top of the house. I'll put you in. So, here's the front yard. That's like a gate. Fence type thing. Fence post. Look at that. Hey. That's pretty good, if I do say so.
Marnie wants to know your favourite Christmas song.
My favourite Christmas song was playing this morning, actually, when I was getting a massage. Mariah Carey, All I Want for Christmas. She's a better singer than I am. I think that's probably half of it, but nice to sing along to. Actually, no, there's no way I'm singing along to that so much. Sprinkle a few of these ones around in there. Marshmallows. It's like grass in the front yard or something, I guess. What else are we missing? Maybe the red.
Me is asking, what's your favourite part about Christmas?
Favourite part about Christmas? I love chocolate and sweet food. And I can't usually have it because I play for the Melbourne Football Club, obviously. So it's I miss it very much. Christmas, I usually have a little bit of an indulgence. I get my sweet tooth and let it off the chain a bit, so. And spending time, I think, as well with my friends and family, that's probably equal first with chocolate a bit. My chocolate's up there.
Angela wants to know if you're cooking anything for the Christmas table. And what your specialty is.
What my specialty is? That's a good question. So there's this one salad that my mum makes. It's like an Asian fusion type setup, which is basically all come out of a packet, so I don't have to do a whole lot, but I chop up the cabbage and sprinkle all the stuff on. I make sure that it looks good, and I think if you're looking at my gingerbread house right now, you'll agree, presentation in this instance is pretty much spot on. So that's a pretty good job. Oh, gee whiz, yeah, no, that's right. I've got the little people. These are people. Born a girl, alright. So, they sit in the front yard, or I'm not exactly sure, to be honest. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to take the squirter out of the equation, because that's a bit hard for me to deal with. I'm just going to dip them straight in and stick them on the front doors, because this is their house. Gonna run one red, one blue. And a Christmas tree. Oh geez. Does that go on?
Is that what it's meant to do? It's meant to come
on. Should we try it? I think we should try it. This could be the make or break. We've come so far, team. Has that stayed up?
Stayed up, yep.
Well, that's it. I think that's the finishing touch, isn't it? Get a few more sprinkles over the top. Make it nice and messy. But yeah, guys, I think that's a pretty good deal. I like the detail of the front yard, really.
Piper said it looks beautiful.
Well, thank you. I feel like people would just like contain themselves to the house, but I've actually gone a bit broader, and I'm thinking about what's going on around the rest of the place. So I appreciate that you've picked up on that, because it, that's what I was going for. I was going for a bit of a holistic look. And now I'm just adding stuff on. I feel like it's not going to collapse on me now. Now that I've said that, it probably will. I'm just making a few final touches. If any of you want to get in contact with the club, I should probably start charging myself this, because I'm doing such a good job. But you have a gingerbread house that you need to put together or anything like that, I'd be happy to help. Yes. A few more little bits and pieces to go on. I'm pretty happy with that. As far as it goes, I mean, it's a bit of a mess, but it's all part of it, isn't it? Any last questions, guys? I've put it all together, so I think there's not much left for me to do here, but is there anything else? Someone's got a rating out of 10.
Haven wants to know if the house is for sale.
The house is just, is it for sale? What do we do with it? Well, I'm not eating it. So, I guess it could be. How much would a house like this be worth? I'm not exactly sure. Thousands, I'm guessing. You know what? I'm going to put the hundreds and thousands on. Just because I've used everything but a few dribbles on the side.
Got a couple of 11 out of 10s.
11s? Well, I feel like that's probably fair. Wanted to grade it, because I think if it was just the gingerbread house, it would be a 10 out of 10, but the front yard's added an extra point. That no one else is available to no one else. It's messy work building your own gingerbread house. So just, if any of you watching at home, be prepared to clean up a fair bit. My hands are pretty messy and they're pink and blue, I think, and they will be for the rest of the week, which is okay. But well done, we've done it. After a real sketchy start, I mean, it fell over a few times, but we're here now, I've built the house, and everyone have a Merry Christmas, and I'll be seeing you around.